In this video, we'll show you how to test the water resistance rating of your watch using a pressure tester. This is the waterproof tester we'll use today. It's simple to use, but we have to be careful every step of the way, because it is a so-called wet test, meaning water is involved. If something is done incorrectly, water can get into the watch and cause irreparable damage. So follow this guide step by step closely. First of all, you need to know the water resistance rating of your watch. You can usually find this on the dial or on the case back. It is usually labelled in ATM or in meters. Then you'll need to translate this figure into bar. A simple formula is 5 ATM equals 50 M equals 5 bars. If you want to know more about the true meaning of this figure, check out our guide on it. For this video, we'll do a 5 ATM test as a demonstration. This is because, for home settings, an affordable tester can usually test up to 6 ATM, such as this tester here, which has a capacity of 6 bars. A 5 ATM test is actually quite sufficient for normal uses, including some water-related activities. Even for a 20 ATM watch, a 5 ATM test is still useful in revealing some fundamental failings of water seals. To test higher ratings, you'll be looking at more specialised equipment. Now, let's set up the test. Fill the chamber with water up to the red line. Use only distilled water to avoid mineral deposit. Then take the watch and push the crown all the way in. Screw it in as well if it's a screw down crown. Then hang the watch with a spring bar onto the hook at the bottom of the lid. But if you don't have a spring bar on hand, you can loop a rubber band around the case like this to create a secure loop. With the watch hooked on, make sure the crown is pushed all the way in and the plunger is pulled to the top. Then place the lid onto the cylinder and screw tight the lid. With the watch above the water, we'll pressurise the chamber by pumping with this crank. We'll now wait about a minute before we release the air from the chamber. This is a good time to explain how the tester works. Simply put, air flows from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. When the chamber is pressurised, if there is any leak in the watch case, air will get into the case. And when the chamber is depressurized, the same air will escape the case. And in the water, you'll see it escaping as a stream of bubbles. Since the bubbles are extra air escaping instead of water getting in, this design has the advantage of minimizing the amount of water getting into the case if used properly. Okay, now it's been a minute, we'll do a preliminary test first. Without putting the watch into the water, we'll slowly release the air from the chamber. This is to eliminate the possibility of a major leakage, which can cause the crystal to explode from the case. Evidently, we don't want this to happen with the watch submerged into the water. Now the pressure is zero and nothing has popped, so this watch passes the preliminary test. We'll now repeat the process. Pump air and wait a minute. But this time, we'll submerge the watch into the water, then start slowly releasing the air at once. Pay close attention to any streams of bubbles emerging from the watch. If you see one, it means there's a water leakage at that particular point on the case, and you should immediately pull up the watch, and then release the rest of the air afterwards. This is to prevent more water from leaking into the case. One or two bubbles are usually only air previously trapped in the gaps of the case, so you need not worry about them. If you are testing a dive watch or other watches with a bezel usually traps quite some air. So if you want to be sure, you can remove the bezel before testing. Make sure you remove the click spring as well. All air has been released, and there was no continuous stream of bubbles. This means the watch passes the test. I'll take out the watch and dry off the case. Check for all the gaps and corners are completely dried. This is how you do a water resistance test using a pressure tester. For this watch that's rated at 20 ATM and has just passed a 5 ATM test, I'd be comfortable wearing it to a dive now. The rationale behind this is a whole topic for another video, but for now, it's good enough to know that my watch is pretty much waterproof. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe for more watchmaking tutorials and tips.